by just the magic and diversity and awe of wild, and to see that being lost for all time to come felt like such a grave betrayal of our role as stewards in this world, that I felt truly internally called from a very young age to speak out against it, to be an active proponent towards preservation measures. Because a lot of why things are the way they are is because people don't know, or they don't know it in the way that they can understand it. So it might be revealed to them as statistics or just, you know, data bytes, but it's not emotionally intuitive. It doesn't create the right level of catalyzation within an individual, because it hasn't reached them on a scale and in a vocabulary that is personally intuitive to them. It's a very interesting time to be alive in, because there are so many perspectives depending on where you are in that storyline, right? And as conservationists, if we approach it solely from the perspective of this needs to be kept alive for its own intrinsic value, it's all well and good, but if the reality and context does not support it, no matter how many times you try to say that, people are not actually going to be a part of that solution process. So to get them to understand it, you need to go on the front lines and talk to them, understand why it's not working for them, and see if there is a tangible solution you can implement to address the human-wildlife conflict point. And being on the ground has allowed me to have those kinds of conversations, to understand truly whether something can or cannot work. And sometimes the campaign needs to start there. That is the first entry point, is to address the locals before you can even get the international community to be involved in the effort of protecting the elephants on the ground. We operate like the developed nations, the post-industrial and industrializing nations, occupy those countries in terms of vested interests, in terms of sending our corporations there to source what we need without any kind of understanding of empowering the local dynamic for its own reasons to be self-protecting and self-sustaining. So you have, like, you know, Dole and Colgate and all these people holding massive acreage in African nations. So African people don't have a say in their own backyard about how their land and resources are managed. My work now, I'm looking more at why the pandemic has even happened. Like, anything that you think about that comes from the animals to either human civilization or humanity itself seems to happen because there's less and less wilderness, buffer zones, areas where there's enough space for wild to do its wild thing, while there's an extant level of biodiversity, which means there's a large array of organisms that these virus bacteria can occupy without pilfering into human civilization. Unfortunately, because as we've taken over more of the world, currently, if you look at global biomass, we are over 97% of global biomass. If we're intelligent as artists or designers, we can leverage platforms that we're able to create to integrate people, voices, brands, such that they can bounce off of each other's PR. So it's all about, like, understanding also publicity and outreach and leveraging communication strategies through the right portals, and as well the right individuals or identities, like brands, personalities, to ensure that the message is advanced cohesively and collectively for maximum impact. You know, beyond your everyday resource impact and how you consume, if you can change your immediate community, if you can change your immediate backyard to engage more positively, then do that. Don't ever give up on people just because they disagree with you. Like, love them for it, because that's where they're at, but they will shift with you if you have an inclusive conversation instead of judge and condemn them for that specific moment of ignorance, because it's all contextual and where we're at because of circumstances, because of life, what we've been exposed to. And having the right, like, soundbite come in at the right time can shift an attitude so quickly. I've seen myself change, I've seen others change. It's highly possible that we'll all change and lead to a better world. So don't lose hope, don't get all doom and gloom, and don't be like, oh, the end of the world is here. It's not. Like, we're gonna do great. Just, like, focus on the light, focus on the right.